Welcome to an introduction to weighted voting. In this lesson, we'll define weighted voting, use shorthand form for weighted voting, and also define dictator, veto power, and a dummy in a weighted voting system. Weighted voting gives some voters different amounts of influence or weight concerning the outcome of an election. This is often common practice when it comes to corporate shareholder meetings, when shareholders' voting weight is based upon how many shares they own. The more shares someone owns, the more weight of their vote. The conditions that must be met for a winner might be a simple majority, but there could also be different requirements to select a winner. Each individual or entity casting a vote is called a player in the election. They're often notated as P1, P2, through P n, where n is the total number of voters. Each player is given a weight, which usually represents how many votes they get. The quota is the minimum weight needed for the vote to pass, or weight needed for the proposal to be approved. A weighted voting system will often be represented in a shorthand form as we see here, where Q is the quota, W1 is the weight of player 1, W2 is the weight of player 2, and so on. Let's take a look at an example. We want to write a possible weighted voting system for the following situation. A company has 5 shareholders. The shareholders hold the following ownership stake in the company, given here as percentages. They are trying to decide if they should invest in a new product line to grow the company. The company bylaws state that a majority of the ownership, more than 50%, has to approve the decision. Because the ownership is given as percentages, and the quota has to be more than 50%, we'll start with the quota, which we'll set at 51, and then a colon, followed by the weight of each ownership, which we can also think of as a number of votes given to a voter based upon their percent of ownership. So we could list the weight as 30, 25, 20, 15, 10. This would be a possible weighted voting system for this situation. But there are an infinite number of weighted voting systems that we could create for this situation. In order to have a meaningful weighted voting system, though, there must be limits on the quota. Number one, the quota must be more than half the total number of votes, because notice how if it wasn't, there could be more weight against a proposal and it could still pass. And number two, the quota can't be larger than the total number of votes, because if it was, no proposal would ever pass. A player will be a dictator if their weight is equal to or greater than the quota. The dictator can also block any proposal from passing. The other players cannot reach quota without the dictator. Looking at this weighted voting system here, notice how player 1 has a weight of 21, which is more than quota, and therefore player 1 is a dictator. Also notice player 1 has the ability to block any proposal, because if player 2 and player 3 form a group, they still only have a weight of 6 plus 3, or 9, way below quota. So we can see again, player 1 is a dictator. Next, a player has veto power if their support is necessary for the quota to be reached. It is possible for more than one player to have veto power, or for no player to have veto power. Looking at this first example here, notice how player 1 is not a dictator, but if player 2 and 3 form a group, they only have a weight of 26, which is below quota. And therefore, player 1 is required to reach quota, and therefore player 1 has veto power. But notice how if player 1 and player 3 form a group, they have a weight of 30, which does reach quota, so player 2 is not required to reach quota. And if player 1 and player 2 form a group, they have a weight of 34, once again more than quota, so player 3 is not required. So again, we can say that player 1 has veto power. Looking at our second example here, notice none of the players are dictators. And if player 1 and player 2 form a group, they reach quota. If player 1 and player 3 form a group, they reach quota. And also if player 2 and player 3 form a group, they reach quota. So no single player is required to reach quota, and therefore no player has veto power. Next, a player is a dummy if their vote is never essential for a group to reach quota. So looking at this system, notice how Looking at this system, notice how player 3 is never required. Player 1 and player 2 can make quota, but player 1 and player 3 cannot reach quota because they have a weight of 14. If player 2 and player 3 form a group, they have a weight of 12, again, which is below quota. And therefore, player 3 is never essential to reach quota, so we can say player 3 is a dummy player. Now let's take a look at some examples to review all these concepts. We want to consider the following weighted voting system. We're first asked how many players there are. There would be 1, 2, 3, 4 players. Next, what is the total number of votes or weight? Well, that would be 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 2, which is 26. So we'll say there's a total of 26 votes. The quota would be 18. Now we want to identify any dictators, but notice how none of the weights are greater than or equal to the quota of 18, and therefore no players are dictators. We also want to identify whether any players have veto power, which means their support is required to reach quota. For example, notice how if we consider player 2, 3, and 4, 8 plus 8 plus 2 is equal to 18, which does reach quota, and therefore player 1 is not required, and we could say the same for player 2 and player 3. And notice if player 1, 2, and 3 form a group, of course they reach quota, so player 4 is not essential, and therefore no players have veto power. We also want to identify any dummy players, where dummy player is a player that's never essential to reach quota. But we just showed that if player 2, 3, and 4 form a group or a coalition, notice 8 plus 8 would be 16, and therefore player 4 is required to reach quota, and therefore player 2 is not a dummy player. So in this case, there are no dummy players. Let's take a look at another example with the same questions, but a different weighted voting system. Again, the first question is, how many players are there? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players. The total number of votes, so the weight would be 18 plus 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1, which would be 30. So we'll say the total number of votes is 30. The quota is here to the left of the colon, so the quota is 16. Notice in this system, we do have a dictator. Notice player 1 has a weight that's greater than or equal to the quota of 16, so player 1 is a dictator. We also want to identify any players that have veto power, which means their votes are required to reach quota. If we consider players 2, 3, 4, and 5, their total weight would be 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1, which would be 12, which is below quota, and therefore notice player 1 would always be required to reach quota, and therefore player 1 has veto power. We also want to identify any dummy players. Remember, a dummy player is never essential to reach quota. Notice if players 2, 3, 4, and 5 form a group or a coalition, they still only have a weight of 12, which is below quota. The only way to reach quota is with player 1's support, and therefore player 2, 3, 4, and 5 are all dummy players since none of them are essential to reach quota. Let's take a look at one more example. Here we don't know the quota, but we are given the weight of the 5 players. The first question is, what is the smallest value that the quota Q can take? Remember, the quota has to be more than half the votes. Remember the quota. So we'll find the sum of these votes, or these weights, and divide by 2. And then Q has to be greater than that value. So we'd have 14 plus 10 plus 6 plus 2 plus 2 divided by 2, which would be 34 divided by 2, which is equal to 17. Remember, the quota has to be more than half, and since half would be 17 votes, or a weight of 17, that means the smallest value of Q would have to be one more than 17, or 18, since we wouldn't use a fraction of a vote or a fraction of a weight. So the smallest value of Q is 18. The largest value would be the total number of votes, which we just found was 34. 14 plus 10 plus 6 plus 2 plus 2. So the largest value of Q is 34, And then finally, what is the value of Q, the quota, if at least two-thirds of the votes are required to pass a motion? Well, that would be two-thirds times 34, 34 over 1. That would be 68-thirds, which comes out to approximately 22.7. So we'd have to round up to 23. So if at least two-thirds of the votes are required, Q would be 23. I hope you found this helpful.